woman came from the bush to the city, it has been nothing but absolute chaos. Unprecedented number of job losses, intimidation and dismissal of public servants, collapsed banks and other financial services, increasing taxes and levies with absolutely no socio-economic benefit from revenues collected. Excessive borrowing, not for infrastructure or asset creation, but on one-time expenditure, feeding a never-satisfied elephant family. And in terms of corruption, Transparency International Corruption Index shows how Ghana is sliding into an abyss under Nanado's corruption clearinghouse. Teachers are worse off. Nurses are confused. Traders are in dire straits. Businesses are collapsing, are closing down. Contractors are wondering if they will ever get paid. Workers see their incomes dwindle in the face of increasing petroleum prices and taxes. Importers now pay taxes far in excess of the value of goods they are importing. But while the populace suffer, official travels and parties of government officials are on the ascendancy. Should it be impossible to complete projects of which funds have already been secured? Should it be too difficult to fill vacancies pending in various infrastructure facilities conceived, built, and funded by the previous administration? Why should the University of Ghana Medical Center and the Maritime Hospital, all built by the Mahama administration, be left unattended to while patients sleep on floors or get told in other medical facilities to go home for lack of hospital beds? Ladies and gentlemen, the records are pretty clear as to what the NDC did when it was given the opportunity to run the affairs of this country. And once again, loud voices of Ghanaians are calling on the NDC to rescue them from the state of hopelessness they find themselves in.